All right, we'll go back to the questions in a minute, but tonight on Homework Hotline, we would like to welcome Judy Cranston and Cheyenne to the show. They are here in honor of Women's History Month and will be talking to us about the Girl Scouts and the issues young women face today. Thank you very much for coming on, Cheyenne.
Thanks for having
us. And thank you, Judy.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.
The mission of your organization is Girl Scouting builds girls of courage, confidence, and character, who make the world a better place. What are some of the things your organization does to meet this mission statement?
Yes, definitely. First of all, the Girl Scouts of Western New York, which is our council, is made up of approximately 18,000 girls and 7,000 volunteer adults. So it's a large council. Mm-hmm. It covers a 9-county area here through Rochester, Genesee, Livingston, Wyoming, Orleans, through Cattaraugus, Chautauqua counties, Erie, and Niagara counties. So we cover a large footprint.
Sure.
But the girls themselves are engaged in leadership activities and fun activities in our focus areas. And those focus areas are STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math, financial literacy, healthy living, environmental leadership, and global leadership.
Good. So why are organizations for women, young women like this, so important?
Well, we need to tell our young women that they are more than just a pretty face, that they are also smart, and they are business savvy, and they are tech savvy, and they can be so many other things. And Girl Scouts does a great job of that because they give girls the opportunity to go out and do anything they want to with full support from parents, friends, peers, and other leaders in the community.
Good.
Wow. What are the ages that girls can partake in the Girl Scouts?
Yeah, 5 through 17.
All right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And that's, will they have different classifications for, like, brownies and...
Absolutely. So there's daisies, brownies, juniors, cadets, seniors, and ambassadors.
Now, how would some of the local girls find out about the troops in their area? Do you go to the schools? How do you get girls to know about these?
Yeah, we do a lot of recruitment events. We go to schools and we do in-school talks. We go to where girls meet, you know, community centers and malls. And obviously, we also have a website, which is gswny.org. So if you're interested in joining a troop or any of the other activities that are engaged in Girl Scouts, just go to that site and you will be able to be hooked up with a troop and have an opportunity to join, or any other activity you choose to get involved in.
Nice. Now, what do you see as issues that young women are facing today, and how can Girl Scouts help them deal with that stuff?
Yeah, well, girls today, obviously, there's a lot of media pressure, social media, you know, TV. Girls today have issues with low self-esteem. There's bullying issues out in the world today. And the Girl Scout Research Institute did some studies, and they were saying about 34% of girls report that they are suffering from depression. And a lot of that is from some of the negative images and the really just misconceptions about girls.
You turn on your TV and you see women objectified as objects or as accessories. Even just subtle things like if you're watching a doctor commercial, more often than not, the doctor is going to be a man, not a woman.
True.
So it's
noticed.
Just little things like that that give girls the idea that they can't be leaders.
Cool.
What are some of the things young women can do to counteract the negative images and the stereotypes of women?
I think one of the things that Girl Scouts does for them is teaches you to believe in yourself, because you always have to be there for you. No one is going to love you unless you love you. And that's one of the things that Girl Scouts gives to girls that they can take on to then go into leadership opportunities, even just going out and selling cookies. You have to have confidence in what you're telling your people, otherwise they aren't going to want to buy cookies from you. And so it's as basic as that.
Judy, what do you think?
Yes, definitely. And, you know, the thing about Girl Scouts, too, because it's a girl organization, they get to do all of these activities and to learn and hone their leadership skills in a very safe and supportive environment, you know, with other girls and leaders that understand the needs of the girls. And they have the opportunity to test out their skills and to challenge some of the misperceptions that are, you know, they're surrounded with, as Cheyenne said, in the world.
So how has this organization helped now, and how does it fit into other things that, because I've heard a lot that Girl Scouts is kind of the numbers have fallen off recently, so how does what you're saying here help build that with Girl Scouts? How does it get the numbers up, and how does that help with the girls do what you're saying here now?
Mm-hmm. Some of the things that we do, and Girl Scouts is still about 2.8 million strong across the nation, so we still have a good membership. But we do a lot of surveying of girls and talking to girls and trying to find out what are the things that are interesting to them. We have a Girl Scout Research Institute that does a lot of data collection from girls and young women to see what are they interested in. And we're adding, for example, today, more of the outdoor type programming. Sure. Girls are telling us they want a white water raft. They want to go on that high ropes course. Yep. So we're doing more and more of that type of programming based on feedback from the girls.
Nice.
So based on that, I'm reading into this a little, and you can help me out, both of you. Do you think that you don't think the equality between the genders is actually over yet?
No.
Certainly not.
You don't?
No, it's just started.
No. Well, I mean, you can just, again, you take a look at what you see on television, even in just commercials. Women are considered accessories. It's about the makeup. It's not about the job or really the skills that you are earning. And so Girl Scouts teaches more than just, like, go have fun and camp out. It teaches business skills through cookie sales. It teaches, like, here I am on TV talking to you because I learned this through Girl Scouts. And so I think that getting involved in Girl Scouts can certainly help girls to open their eyes to the inequality that is in the world, because some of them just don't see it.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the other interesting thing, you know, when you think about with girls is that, you know, when the data says that like 75% of girls say that they're interested in STEM careers, yet only 25% of the STEM careers are held by women. And many times, you know, they drop out of STEM activities earlier, like say in middle school, because all of a sudden they lose confidence in their skills to be able to perform as well, even though, you know, up until then, they've shown total aptitude to be able to keep up with anyone in the class.
Sure.
So there's some misperceptions and there's some encouragement and role modeling that's needed for the girls so that we can make sure that they continue on that path.
And with that statement, you're saying that the girls shouldn't be scared of taking on leadership roles. And how, as a young woman, could you do that?
Just have confidence in yourself. And Girl Scouts has an amazing support network of people. When you want to be in a leadership experience, there will always be someone there who says, yes, go and do that.
Very good.
Absolutely, yes. And Cheyenne's a wonderful example of leadership.
Thank you.
What advice would you give to girls or young women that are watching us right now?
Well, first, if you're not a Girl Scout, join. That would be a great idea. But I think it's don't let what society is telling you be your guide. Let your heart be your guide. Let your role models be your guide. And I think, you know, be confident that you can achieve anything. And I think as women move forward and young girls are told that they can do it and are engaged in supportive opportunities where they get the opportunity to practice those skills, they'll succeed.
Excellent.
Certainly. Okay. You hit the nail on the head with that one.
Yeah. Well, we're going to say thank you very much, Cheyenne.
Thank
and
you.
Judy, for coming on today.
Thanks so much. Thanks for having
us.
Thank you.
Okay, to learn more about Women's History Month and the Girl Scouts, go to our website, homeworkhotline.org, and click on the Women's History Month button. Now stay right there, and we'll be back in a second.